Former Professor of Education at the University of Otago, Dan McKerricker, was part of a visionary group 35 years ago that set up the Mosgiel Family Health Counselling Centre. It was the first of its kind in New Zealand at the time and brought together the Health Board, the Education Department and the Department of Psychological Medicine in the late 1970s.
We had a really a very powerful team. And interestingly, it was the only one in the country at that stage. 40 years ago, there weren't health centres. And Mosgiel was, as far as I know, was the first to have that integrated concept using the community.
The work was focused around helping vulnerable people in the community. But by bringing together and integrating mental health services, more cases could be dealt with. McKerricker says the three-year follow-up that patients had was research-based and showed a 63% improvement with fewer relapses. And he's pleased to see the hard work is still being put into the service today.
I'm interested to see that it still survives, and I've just spoken to the director, and I'm absolutely thrilled that they've been able to maintain it and keep it going. And it will be developing in new directions, I'm sure.
The current clinical manager at the Family Mental Health Service says it covers about 50% of the population from Mosgiel to Dunedin.
We receive about 500 referrals a year, and that's been consistent over a number of years. So I guess the service is very embedded within the community and obviously well supported.
Today's celebration gave credit to those who had a vision and created a legacy that continues to help mental health sufferers to this day. Dee Karen, 39 Dunedin News.